So, hallo und herzlich willkommen zurück zu Let's Play 999. Beim letzten Mal haben wir die vollständige Vorgeschichte von Seven erfahren. Er hat seine gesamten Erinnerungen zurück und das ist alles ziemlich verwirrend irgendwie, also wirklich ziemlich verwirrend. Anscheinend ist Santa wirklich Zero und Akane war seine Schwester, die verbrannt ist. Und wer ist Akane? Also wer ist June, eher gesagt? Ich weiß es ja nicht. Ich habe keine Ahnung, was abgeht. Und ich würde sagen, wir machen aber weiter. Wir sind gerade aus dem letzten Escape Room entkommen. Also aus dem letzten, in dem wir gerade drin waren, meine ich. Nicht aus dem letzten. Weiß nicht, ob noch einer kommt, aber ich meine, so viel wie hier noch übrig ist. Kommt bestimmt noch einer. Bin ich mir recht sicher. Aber gut. Gehen wir mal.
I think the shaking stopped.
Sind wir einfach nur zurückgegangen gerade?
It would seem so, but we are yet to be out of danger.
Ach ja, klar, wir haben ja nur den Schlüssel da gesucht, ne, den wir brauchen, um weiterzukommen im Hauptgang.
You're right. Let's hurry.
They run across the hallway.
This exit needs the Uranus card too.
Straight for the large metal door. Next to the door was the Uranus card reader.
Hey, Junpei.
Yeah, I know.
They sent the key card through and the door rumbled
All
open.
right, it's open. Let's go.
Out of the library and into the hallway they ran. At the end of the hallway was a door. Junpei reached into his pocket to pull out the key as he ran toward it.
Okay, Neptune Key, let's see if you work. Yes! Oh, I think it unlocked.
Ah, der Incinerator, ja, den kenne ich tatsächlich schon. In front of them was another great metal door. Above it was a metal plaque.
It says incinerator. So
Yep.
this is the incinerator.
This is the first time I've seen it from this side, but yeah, I think so.
Ja, dachte ich auch gerade. Also in den Erinnerungen, die wir gesehen haben, sah das ein bisschen anders aus.
Then there ought to be a lever near the door. Yeah, right here.
Jumper ran up to it.
Pull that and the door should open. Got it.
As he spoke, he pulled the lever. The motor in the door groaned as it slowly ground open. There was no time to
Let's
waste.
go.
As soon as the door had opened far enough to admit them, all four dashed through. Then suddenly, there before them were the four who they'd parted from earlier. Und die sollten jetzt erstmal überrascht darüber sein, dass, naja, Snake hier ist. Ace and Lotus stood in front of the number 9 door. Sander wurde geschlagen. Sander was curled into a ball against the wall of the incinerator, holding his stomach. And then there was June. She sat slumped against the wall, exhausted.
What the hell is going on?
Das wüsste ich auch gerne. Jumper ran toward June. He skidded to a stop in front of her and knelt
What's
down.
wrong? Are you okay?
Her face was pale and her lips dry. When she spoke, he could barely hear her. Ja, unter anderem, aber eigentlich bin ich einfach nur hier, weil ich gerne weiter möchte und irgendwo muss ich ja hinlaufen, ne?
Of course I did. I made a promise.
I'm so glad you're here. So glad.
She mumbled the same words over and over, weakly. Junpei could feel his heart breaking.
What happened to you?
I'm fine. I just fainted. I wasn't feeling very good. I'm feeling a lot better now, though.
Are you sure?
Yes. I just need to rest a little longer. I'm sure I'll be fine. You shouldn't worry about me.
She was looking towards Santa. Junpei turned to look as well.
Santa.
Santa grimaced, his face contorted in pain. Seven grabbed him by the collar and roared at him.
Hey, where is it? Where's the gun? You hide it somewhere?
Warum liegt er auf dem Boden rum? Was ist los mit ihm? Despite himself, a grunt of pain escaped Santa's lips as Seven shook
I
him.
don't have it. I got sucker punched and they took the gun.
What? Who took it?
What? Isn't that obvious?
Ace?
I took the gun.
Ja, dachte ich mir doch fast. Ah, well.
Ace.
Das kommt mir irgendwer bekannt vor, dieses CG. Kann man nochmal schön recyceln direkt, ne? He did indeed have the revolver in his hand. It was pressed against Lotus's temple. Ace had a pin to him with the other arm, and she was shaking visibly. The fiery attitude was gone, replaced by fear. She didn't dare speak. There was sweat on her forehead, and when her eyes weren't flicking up to the gun pressed against her, they seemed to desperately want to say something.
Just what the hell do you think you're doing, Ace?
Or maybe I ought to say Gintaro Hongo, CEO of Cradle Pharmaceuticals.
Seven City baritone rumble shook the walls. Ace sneered.
You have me at a disadvantage, and I don't like that. You know me, but I don't know you.
Tja, so ein Scheiß aber auch, aber eigentlich solltest du ihn kennen.
Do you have any idea how much I've suffered? Can you even begin to understand my pain?
Naja, wobei, du kannst dein Gesicht eigentlich erkennen von damals, ne? Ergibt schon Sinn.
The pain of prosopagnosia, right?
Wie kommst du auf die Idee? Junpei's voice was casual. Or at least it was trying to be.
Another irritating insect. And how do you know that?
Good question.
Junpei couldn't say, he just knew. Another unexplainable mystery.
No matter. If you don't want to answer, it makes no difference to me. This is a waste of time anyway. It's time for me to go.
Behind Ace, Junpei could see the red. It was placing the small indentation on the wall. Quickly, Ace placed his hand on the scanner.
First is 1.
Ja, und dann 8 und dann 9. Ich weiß schon. It beeped and he force loaded his hand onto it as well.
8. And with this...
Then at last, he reached into the pocket of his jacket, he pulled something out and pressed it against the panel. The third asterisk appeared on the red.
9.
Und natürlich eine 9 und deswegen, Ace, ergibt halt keinen Sinn. Also diese ganze Theorie von Snake, die er hatte, von wegen, dass die 6 von June eigentlich eine umgedrehte 9 ist und so weiter. Das ergibt keinen Sinn, weil wir dann trotzdem noch 2 9 hätten. Und das würde halt einfach gar nichts erklären von dem Problem, was wir hatten. Und das Problem war, gibt es 2 Sechsen. Also das erklärt halt gar nichts. The thing he had used as a final verification was a bracelet with the number 9.
The ninth man. Kubota's bracelet.
I believe I've won this game.
His smirk made Junpei's blood boil.
I've had quite a time playing with you. I must thank Zero, I suppose.
Wait, what? Ace doesn't know who Zero is.
Junpei's eyes flicked towards Center. He hadn't moved since they'd entered the room. Center was still holding his stomach and groaning as if in immense pain. Junpei wasn't sure if it was real pain, but he wasn't sure it wasn't either.
What the hell are you planning, Center?
At any rate, this game ends now. I will escape, and the rest of you will have a slightly less pleasant ending. I suggest you enjoy your final moments. Goodbye.
Wir hatten schon viele nicht so schöne Enden eigentlich. Ich will mal ein schönes Ende langsam, okay?
Wait!
Ace, of course, paid no heed to Sam's request and laid hold of the lever on the red. With a sickening sense of finality, he pulled it. Und weg ist er, denke ich mal.
Why isn't it opening?
Willst du mir sagen, die 9 ist wirklich keine 9? Was? Hä?
One more time.
Gar nichts, ergibt gerade Sinn in meinem Kopf. It's the last second, he grabbed hold of her wrist and shoved it onto the red.
Now open!
He waved the number 9 bracelet over the red and then his own bracelet as well. He pulled the lever a second time.
What is this? Why?
Wobei ich mich an der Frage, wie ist er durch die erste Nonna-Tür gekommen überhaupt? Ich meine, das... Wobei, da waren ja June und... Ja, klar, okay. Dann war der 9. Mann die ganze Zeit über der 6. Mann, oder was? Jetzt im Ernst?
That digital route should be 9! It has to be 9!
What the fuck?
Then why? Why isn't it opening?
Ace's fury and confusion had overridden all other thoughts. He had set down the revolver. It was just below the red.
Now!
Seven chose that moment to act. He moved far faster than a man of his bulk should have been able to, and he launched that bulk straight at Ace. Okay! Knock ihn um, bitte! Danke! It was over before they knew it.
No!
In the blink of an eye, Ace was on the floor. He rolled onto his side, groaning in pain. Lotus ran straight for Junpei. She darted around him, around behind him and stuck her head out, making sure to keep Junpei between herself and Ace. Ja, danke.
Oh, that was close. Too close. Thank you, Seven.
Don't mention it.
Seven stood over Ace, is breathing slow and heavy.
Just one punch ain't enough for this piece of shit. After what he did 9 years ago, I ought to rip him to pieces. But if a suspect can't talk, they ain't much good. Once he's locked up in a cell, we're gonna have a little chat.
9 years ago? Then you must be...
Yeah, you finally figured it out, dumbass.
Ace planted his hands on the floor and shook his head. Junpei walked toward him. He stopped and looked down at Ace with pity on his face.
Ace, you killed Kubota, Nijisaki, and Musashido, didn't you?
Wait, Nijisaki?
He pitied Junpei, genuinely confused.
Oh, right. You don't know yet. Alright, we'll just go through them in order then. Let's start off with Kubota. You talked to Kubota and managed to convince him to go into Door 5 alone. You killed him without making it look like you killed him. The way I figure it, you had four motives.
Nein, du zählst jetzt nicht auf.
One.
Nein, ich hasse dich. Ich weiß. Das haben wir jetzt schon aufgezählt bekommen von ihm. Ich muss das nicht nochmal hören.
He knew you needed four. But you used Kubota as a test.
Was wirklich?
Break the rules so you
Nein.
That was why you killed Kubota. But he was only the first.
Richtig.
Next was Nijisaki. While everyone was off looking for the missing parts for the Reds, you ran into Nijisaki near the big hospital room. However, because of your prosopagnosia, you didn't realize he was Nijisaki. Chiefly because, when you met him, he was dressed like Snake. That was why you thought Nijisaki was Snake.
No, that's not... That was Nijisaki?
Tatsächlich.
Why? How did...
Gute Frage.
I'll get to that. Anyway, you thought he was Snake. Snake was one of the kids in your experiment 9 years ago. You remembered him because he was the blind kid. But his presence made you think. Snake was one of my subjects 9 years ago. He probably hates me. But if that's true, why isn't he saying anything? Is he keeping quiet because he can't see? Or perhaps he's working with Zero to get revenge on me? Whatever the reason, anyone who knows my past is a threat. Before he tries anything, I need to get rid of him. That was when you decided you had to kill him. The murder weapon was Kubota's bracelet. You just waved it over the Red. Verified your own number and then grabbed Nijisaki's arm and forced it over the scanner panel. Then, when the door opened, you kicked him in. 9 seconds later, the door closed. And then 81 seconds passed. And poor Nijisaki was dead.
And you mean to say, Snake is still alive?
Yep, und er ist direkt hier übrigens.
Sorry to disappoint you, but I'm as good as new. Thank you for killing the wrong man. But I can't say I like knowing that you wanted me dead. Although, to be honest, even if you hadn't tried to kill me, I would still hate you very much.
Verständlicherweise.
Well, I wouldn't blame you.
Immerhin siehst du es ein. Ace's self-derision was frustrating. But Junpei kept his emotions in check and continued.
Last but not least, let's talk about Musashido's death. When Clover and I were investigating the chart room, you came over to talk to me. Do you remember what you said?
Oh, a pocket watch. Might I take a look at it?
Ja, daran erinnere ich mich noch, aber ich... Womit hat das was zu tun?
I handed it to you, and you left the room. You had been in charge of the Nonary Project.
Oh, das heißt, er kannte schon die Lösung von dem Rätsel und ist deswegen schon durchgegangen, hat dann den Captain schon umgebracht und ist dann zurückgekommen? Jetzt im Ernst?
Of course you would have known the solution to every puzzle. Which would mean that you also knew how to get out of the wheelhouse. All you had to do was place the watch in the indentation on the door to unlock it. With the door open, you could enter the captain's quarters.
Hä? Aber wieso sollte der Captain denn da sein? War das eigentlich so gedacht, dass wir als Rätsel dann mit dem Captain zusammen im Raum sind und mit ihm zu reden? Yo, yo, was geht ab? Lass mal ein paar coole Puzzle lösen, machst du mit? Ja, woo! Ich bin übrigens Zero. Ach cool, dich haben wir gesucht, wie schön. Hä?
Musashido was there. Conveniently placed next to him was an axe that practically begged you to kill him.
Das ergibt keinen Sinn, das ist cool und dämlicher Bullshit gerade, tut mir leid.
You picked up that axe and buried the blade deep in the other man's chest. One blow was all it took, and then you returned to the chart room as if nothing had happened.
There was something I wanted to speak with you about, Junpei. Could you come with me for a moment?
I had no reason to say no, so I followed you to the wheelhouse. When we stepped inside, remember how you slipped your hand into my vest? You pulled out a piece of paper, the one I used to cheat during the vote. But that wasn't really what you were after. Your true purpose had been to slip the watch into my pocket. It wasn't a very good plan. Had way too many holes, and someone saying the wrong thing could have brought it all down around you. You must have been desperate. But what made you willing to risk it all to do it?
Ich verstehe gerade gar nicht, was du meinst, ganz ehrlich gesagt, aber ist in Ordnung. Machen wir weiter. Ich meine, was hat das... Die Tatsache, dass er dir die Uhr zurückgegeben hat, mit irgendwas zu tun gerade?
Musashido's murder is the only one I don't understand. You obviously did it. But why?
Because of this.
Slowly, Ace reached down and pulled something out of his pocket. It was a folded piece of paper.
What's with the paper?
Just read it.
Huh. I took it and opened it.
Let's see.
This was what it said.
Number one, there are two ways you might survive this ordeal. The first is to win the nonary game. The second is for you to confess your sins of 9 years past. I have prepared a camera in the captain's quarters. The images captured by that camera will be streamed through a satellite and distributed across the world. Simply look into the camera and repent. Once you have confessed everything, I will release you from this ship. To make your confession more credible, I have left you a witness in the captain's quarters. Perhaps he will confess with you. The decision is yours. Do as you please. Zero.
When I awoke in that room on D-Deck, I found that in my pocket. That was why I chose door one when we voted. If I went through that door, I knew I could get to the captain's quarters. As you said, I knew how to enter the wheelhouse. My plan was to find the pocket watch before anyone else. If I could, then my alibi would be set. At least, that was the plan. Unfortunately for me, you got to it first. That sleight of hand was the best I could manage on short notice.
You meant to kill him from the beginning then? Musashido, I mean.
I only knew Musashido was the witness after I reached the captain's quarters. I asked him, and he answered. He seemed groggy. Perhaps he had only just awoken from sedation. I suppose Nijisaki was in much the same state. He seemed confused and disoriented when I encountered him. But yes, you are correct. I intended to kill him from the beginning, even though I didn't know who he was. I proceeded to the captain's quarters in order to remove this so-called witness.
Ace had confessed everything. Naja, aber leider nicht auf die Art und Weise, wie es eigentlich sollte, nicht wahr? What energy he had left him of the truth, and he sagged on his knees. Although he had confessed, his sins were not forgiven. Junpei felt revulsion for the pathetic man on the floor near his feet. But in among the revulsion was a hint of pity. After all, Ace had not been the only person who murdered those three men. Junpei spoke quietly.
Ace, you figured it out, haven't you? You were being manipulated.
Was? Nein, wirklich?
Yes, so it would seem. I was little more than a puppet, in many ways. Everywhere I went, everything was already prepared. The reds in the large hospital room were dismantled. Nijisaki was dressed like Snake. There was an axe in the captain's quarters. Musashido was delirious from the anesthetic, so he couldn't fight back. Nijisaki as well. In retrospect, I can't understand how I could have fallen into such a simple trap.
Okay, ich nehme damit auch zurück dann, dass es keinen Sinn ergibt, dass da einfach eine Axt rumlag und der da so rumsaß in dem Raum und so. Es war halt so geplant, dass er sie umbringt. Okay, dann akzeptiere ich das doch als Begründung. Tut mir leid.
But yes. Yes. This was a trap. It was Zero's trap. And I fell for it, hook, line and sinker. I did everything he wanted me to do.
Ja, du hast sie alle umgebracht. Deine eigenen Freunde.
Ja.
Quasi.
By manipulating you, Zero was able to kill 3 people and keep the blood off his own hands. All of this was revenge for what happened 9 years ago. That's why this Nonary game happened. Am I right, Santa?
Was? Jumper looked over at Santa. As Jumper spoke, he stood up, his legs still shaky.
Huh? What the hell are you talking about? I don't know any...
Ain't no point trying to play dumb anymore, Santa. Actually, I guess I should call you Aoi Kurashiki, huh? My memory came back to me, kid. You're Aoi Kurashiki, no doubt about it. Never thought I'd be back in this room talking to you. But hey, I guess this was all part of your plan, right? After all, the person who planned the Nonary game this time around was Zero, and Zero's you.
Looks like you really do have your memories back, huh?
Santa's smile was sarcastic and something else.
Well, I guess there's no point in hiding it then, huh? Yeah, you got me. I'm Aoi Kurashiki.
Könnte jetzt auch mal jemand erwähnen, wie June heißt, angeblich jedenfalls.
I was one of the kids in the Nonary game 9 years ago. I made it out. So did Snake over there. But there's one thing... I guess there's 2 things you got wrong. Number 1, I ain't Zero.
Ah, gut.
What?
Wait, what?
Sure, I was helping Zero out, but I'm really more of an assistant. But an assistant's only an assistant. I didn't come up with all this. All I did was follow Zero's orders.
Then, if you're not Zero, who is?
Calm down there, Junpei. Didn't I say 2 things? You made 1 more mistake. Junpei, you just said all of this was revenge for what happened 9 years ago. That's why this Nonary game happened. But that's not it. Revenge isn't the only purpose.
Nicht. Das war das, wovon ich ausging eigentlich.
There's another reason you guys were playing the Nonary game. To save someone.
Save someone?
Right. You were brought here to help my sister. To save Akane.
Was?
What the hell are you talking about? Akane Kurashiki died 9 years ago in this room. I was there. I saw...
Suddenly Seven froze. His eyes went as wide as dinner plates, and he spun around toward June. Ja, gut. June followed his gaze.
What?
She was gone. Was zur Hölle? Where June had been, there was nothing.
What the hell? Where is she? Where's Akane Kurashiki?
Sie hat nie existiert. Seven began to mumble to himself, a strange series of words thrown together as if his mind wasn't functioning properly. His face was twisted with effort, as though he were struggling with something that they couldn't see. He gritted his teeth and pressed his hands against the sides of his head.
Oh, my head! My head, it feels like it's gonna pop!
Seven! What the hell is going on?
I don't know, I just... Oh, I swear to God, my head feels like it's about to explode!
From somewhere far away, they all heard a deep, heavy noise. It sounded like a tremendous wheel slowly beginning to turn. Santa seemed to have entered an almost trance-like state. His words were calm and measured.
What was the Nonary Project? I'm sure you know already, but I'll tell you one more time.
Nein, nicht komplett, bitte.
It was a project designed to test a particular phenomenon.
Ja, ich weiß.
And what was that phenomenon?
Ich weiß es.
Two organisms to communicate with one another in the absence of physical contact.
Ja, so im Prinzip, ja.
The morphogenetic field theory. Could human beings use these invisible fields to exchange information? That was what this experiment was conducted to determine. There were 2 separate locations. One was the Gigantic, and the other was a building in Nevada called Building Q. The 9 children trapped in Building Q were faced with numerous puzzles. Copies of identical ones on the Gigantic, they were told to send their answers into the morphic field set and transmit them to their brothers and sisters on the Gigantic.
Ja, und wie gesagt, dann ergibt es weiterhin keinen Sinn, warum du und Akane beide auf dem Schiff waren. Angeblich jedenfalls. Wie kann das sein?
The transmitters were put in Building Q and the receivers were put on the Gigantic. Each sibling pair was supposed to be split up. But,
ah, aber, gut.
But there was a mistake. Akane was a transmitter. She should have been in Building Q.
However, for some reason, she was placed on the Gigantic with the receivers, like me. Perhaps she was mistaken for someone who was supposed to be in Group A. Whatever the case, Akane ended up on the Gigantic.
Also gab es eine Person, die sehr ähnlich sah und die ist ins Gebäude gekommen und das ist jetzt die, die hier ist, oder was? Das ergibt auch keinen Sinn, ich habe keine Ahnung.
I think I've told you enough. You get it, don't you?
Nein.
I'm pretty sure you know where this is going, Junpei.
Nein.
Where what is going? Don't play dumb.
Ich bin aber dumm, es tut mir leid.
You know things you shouldn't. Things you couldn't.
Achso, ja, das weiß ich.
How did you know Ace had prosopagnosia? How did you know why Ace wanted to kill Kubota and how Nijisaki was killed? Were you surprised when you found out Ace was Hongo? And what about the coffin Snake was trapped in? How the hell did you open it?
Well, that's...
The answer to that is easy. Das morphogenetische Feld! He knew because I knew! Huh? Junpei was receiving information that I sent to him through the morphic field set. Wer ist ich? Wer ist der Erzähler? Warte, was? Okay. Mir ist nie wirklich aufgefallen, dass der Erzähler die ganze Zeit über aus der dritten Person spricht. Ich habe das einfach so hingenommen. Aber wenn man so drüber nachdenkt, in Visual Novels ist eigentlich der Erzähler immer in der ersten Person. Das fällt mir halt jetzt erst auf. What the fuck? It's simple, really. Ist das so? How do I know the alternate future, Zen? Imagine a river that splits in two, like an upside-down Y. The river flows from the top to the bottom, from a single stream into two branches. If it only flows in one direction, it can never flow backward. Information is the same way. It moves from the past to the future, but never flows backward. That's why people at the river's source in the past will never know about the stone stream in the future. But the people downstream will never know about one another either. Information only flows along the path of the river. But I am different. I can manipulate the morphic field set to pluck knowledge from the future. I know what happens on either fork of the river. Even though the people on either fork know nothing about one another. Bin ich einfach I, also wortwörtlich jetzt gerade, als Spieler? Weil ich meine, das würde halt Sinn ergeben, ne? Das war ja so ein ähnlicher Gedanke, den ich schon mal hatte, im Prinzip. Vor einer Ewigkeit. Now, who am I? Ja, danke. I am I. So nein, the letter of the alphabet. Achso, okay, klar. But I am also zero. No, that's not true. I'm not really zero. Not yet. Perhaps you could say I am less than zero. Ah, klar. Ja, was auch sonst. Mhm. Zero is my future. In 9 years, I will be zero. What? Wait, what? Ich verstehe gar nichts. Tut mir leid. Where did she go? Ich kann nicht mehr aus dem Adventure Screen raus. June. No, Akane. Where did you go?
Santa!
Why is Clover? Oh shit.
Freeze.
Oh shit. Santa's got the gun. Guess he picked it up when we weren't watching. Looks like he's turned the tables on Ace though. Wonder who he likes having a gun to his head. Okay, jetzt bin ich aber der Erzähler, der Junpei ist hier im Adventure-Mode. Oh Mann! Ja, okay, es ergibt irgendwie Sinn. Ich habe ja schon mal am Anfang des Spiels gesagt, dass das Spiel original für den DS erschienen ist und es da so war, dass auf dem oberen Bildschirm immer diese Textboxen waren. Und auf dem unteren Bildschirm diese ganzen, ja, Erzähltexte waren, die halt hier einfach zusammen auf den einen Bildschirm geklatscht wurden und man konnte halt hin und her wechseln und bla bla. Und ich stelle mir das also gerade so vor, dass gerade der untere Bildschirm ausgeschaltet wurde. Und wir jetzt nur noch die Textboxen sehen. Ergibt das Sinn? Ich glaube, so ist das eigentlich gerade, wenn wir es auf dem DS spielen würden.
Get up.
Sure isn't about to take that gun off him for a minute, is he? Ace isn't putting up any kind of fight. I mean, I don't think I would either, but he just looks kinda drained. I guess he's going for the door, huh? He does need to verify to go through the door, but...
Hey, what's your plan, Santa? What are you doing?
He can't get through any numbered doors with just two people. What else is he thinking?
Didn't I tell you? I'm Santa Claus. It's time for me to go make a wish come true.
That's it? That's all he's gonna give us? What the hell does that even mean? Shit, they're out. And now the gate's shut. Looks like the rest of us are stuck in here. They are all looking at me. At least Seven's headache is gone. He seems to be alright. I guess there's no harm in trying. Let's see if this door still opens.
Damn! Well, it looks like this door isn't opening anytime soon.
Oh, you mean we're trapped?
So it would seem.
What the hell is Santa trying to do?
Oh my gosh!
Oh my gosh, what?
Have you considered where we are? There can really only be one thing Santa would do now.
No. No, you can't be serious.
Okay, Leute, wir haben noch schöne 18 Minuten gemeinsam als Freunde. Oh, but yes, shit, we've got to do something. We can still get out through door 9. There's the rat. Yeah, alright, we can do this. I've just gotta... No, it's not gonna work. There's no way. My boss can't open this door. That's richtig. Wir brauchen Ace. Is there any combination that'll work?
Junpei, can I borrow your pen and notebook?
Sure, why not? I think I'm going to need them ever again. Well, she certainly looks purposeful. Looks like she's writing equations, a lot of them. Oh man, she doesn't look very happy. What? Hey, no! No need to be ripping pages out like that! Jeez!
What the hell are you doing, Clover? Give me that!
Alright, at least Seven got it away from her. Maybe now I can get a look at what she's writing. Let's see. Und wer fehlt da? Wer ist noch hier? Ich weiß gerade gar nicht, wer hier ist. Ist Lotus noch hier?
What?
Ja, Lotus ist noch hier, klar.
And there's no other way.
Lotus. Looks like she'd figured it out too. And this is just too cruel.
It's okay.
Lotus.
Come on, you know we can't do that.
Don't give me that. I'm sure you'd love to get rid of me.
God damn it, you idiot!
Whoa, where the hell did that come from? Looks like she expected that about as much as I did.
If you're not... Look, it'd be bad, alright?
For a cop, he sure doesn't have much confidence.
Bad?
Yeah. If there weren't assholes like you around, I'd be out of a job.
Das ist so gut, Bruno.
Look, I'm just not leaving you behind, alright? End of story.
Aber wir haben keine Wahl. Okay, vielleicht haben wir eine Wahl. Wahrscheinlich passiert gleich noch irgendwas Wundervolles.
Seven.
He's right. I'm not leaving you either.
Me too.
You didn't honestly think I'd abandon you, did you?
You're all idiots.
Act as tough as you want, Lotus. We can all see you're about to cry.
That being said, however, I doubt we would be able to open the door anyway, even if we were to leave Lotus behind.
Huh? Why?
I trust you remember what happened to Ace. I couldn't, see exactly what happened, but I was able to guess what he was attempting to do earlier, at the Red.
Und zwar...
Oh, yeah.
No! What is this? Why?
Ja, das Problem war, dass das neunte Armband versucht hat zu benutzen und es war offensichtlich nicht wirklich eine neun oder so, glaube ich.
The digital route should be 9! It has to be 9! Then why? Why isn't it opening?
Just to see. Why don't we give it a shot?
Give it a shot?
Yes, that is what I said.
Oh, das geht wirklich nicht. Was sollen wir dann tun?
You were right.
It ain't opening.
But it did open 9 years ago. The digital route was 9 then, I'm sure of it. You think maybe they changed the settings? Perhaps.
Shit. Yeah. If we can't get through the door, we can't get out. So what's a way to hide? There's no way in hell we could get to that hole 7 popped out 9 years ago. All I can do is stand here and stare at this door with a 9 on it. I guess this is it. This is the end. Morphogenetisches Feld, rette mich! Bitte! Warte mal, was? I was watching... Der Erzähler ist also Akane? I'd watch everything that was reflected in his eyes. I was listening. Every sound that vibrated in his eardrums I heard. Smell, taste, touch. I felt everything he felt. I knew everything about him. What he was thinking, what he was feeling, what he was sensing. All of his feelings and worries and fears became mine. My mind, my consciousness was inside of him. Through the morphic field set, we were resonant. We were as one. I was him, and at the same time, I was an observer. It started with a tremendous noise, like a clap of thunder. It was approximately 9 hours ago. A bomb had gone off on the ship we were on. That was when my resonance had with him began. A resonant event melted into him and we became one. Inside of Junpei. Scheiße! Warte mal, willst du mir gerade sagen? Die Szene mit dem Fahrstuhl. Ihr wisst genau, welche Szene ich meine. War Foreshadowing hier rein, wo sie gesagt hat, ja, wenn es in dich eindringt, ist es eher so, naja, normalerweise dringt es nicht so in den Typen ein. Egal, okay, gut. Somehow I found myself in Junpei's mind. Nein, yes, in the future. Ach so, natürlich, okay, klar, das halt auch noch. But I didn't lose myself. I was living in two realities at once. One was the present and the other was the future. Perhaps you can think of it as two movies showing on the same screen at the same time. Warte, was? Nein, es gibt zwei Bildschirme übereinander, da bin ich mir ganz sicher. Oh fuck. Ja, das Spiel gehört einfach auf die DS, das merkt man jetzt gerade ziemlich stark, glaube ich. Eventually, it becomes difficult to separate them and determine which movie is which. However, if I concentrated, I was able to focus on one or the other. That was why I was able to grasp what was happening in front of me.
Come on, over here!
That was my brother Aoi. He was yelling. I followed him. Around me were seven other children. They looked like they were about my age.
Come on, hurry up!
We ran down a long straight hallway and burst into the large hospital room. Everyone was arguing. Two of the boys got in a fist fight. A girl was watching them, began to cry. I wanna go home, she cried. I wanna go home. Another girl slapped the crying girl and glared down at her. It has been 2 hours since an honorary game began. We were starting to fall apart. But just when all hope seemed lost, Light started talking. He was blind. 9 years later, he would call himself Snake.
Hello? Everyone? Could you come over here for a moment?
He was older than most of us, and his voice had authority and dignity. The fights died down and we gathered around him.
I have a little sister. She is very important to me.
Ja, ich glaube, das haben die meisten Typen hier.
Right now, she is over in Building Q and is desperately trying to send information over to me. Her name is Clover and today is her 9th birthday.
Sie heißt wirklich Clover? Was? As he spoke, he pulled something from his pocket. In his hand were 9 four-leaf clovers.
I was going to give these to her as a birthday present. I was outside picking them when I was abducted. I'm sure I've already told you, but I am blind. For a man who can't see, collecting 9 of a very specific plant is, well, it is difficult.
Das wäre auch sonst schon ziemlich difficult, glaube ich.
But my sister means a great deal to me, and I hope that these would show her how much I cared for her. Since it's her 9th birthday, I thought 9 four-leaf clovers would be appropriate.
Why are you so cute, though?
Every one of you has a brother or a sister in Building Q with Clover. For their sake, we have to survive. We have to get off this ship. Do you understand? If we're going to do that, there are 3 things you have to remember. We need trust and love, and we have to have faith in one another. If we can take all 3 of those to heart, then I promise that good luck will come our way.
Ja, ja, habe ich schon mal gehört.
Did you know that the leaves on the four-leaf clover mean faith, trust, love, and luck? Those words are leaf words. So if you believe what I've told you, and you understand, then I want you each to have one of these. They're a promise between friends.
Eventually he was left with only a single four-leaf clover. He had one less thing to say.
Don't ever forget, so long as you have that, we will always be connected. Do you understand?
When he finished, the tension of only a few minutes before was gone. We were calm. After that, we ran around the ship for a while longer and opened several of the numbered doors until we finally found a door with the number 9 on it. In fact, there were two doors with 9 on them, and we found some in the chapel. We split into two groups and walked through the doors. Yeah, bis sie beim Incinerator ankamt. Before long, we all found ourselves in a room with a ceiling that looked like an upside-down funnel. For some reason, this room had another number 9, but this time was only the only one. But if there was only one door, that meant only 5 people could escape.
What are we gonna do? There aren't any other doors!
We began to panic. And as if things had not gotten bad enough already. Ich weiß. No.
What? What's happening? What did that thing say? That didn't sound good.
Rosa, we swallowed hard and answered.
I think it means this room is gonna burn.
Ja, das glaube ich auch tatsächlich.
Burn!
A plaque on the door says incinerator, and that voice said that the incineration is about to start. And incinerate means to burn.
Abject terror filled the room as everyone began to scream and cry. Every pair of eyes were filled with despair. Then... Ja, dann kam der Typ da raus, ich weiß. And years later, we would call him Seven.
Don't worry, kids, I'm not your
enemy.
I'm one of the good guys.
Heißt es, Akane konnte durch die Augen von Junpei aus 9 Jahren in der Zukunft sehen. Okay, akzeptiere ich noch. Und wer war dann Jun? Weiterhin frage ich mich das ein bisschen eventuell. Oder... Nee, ich habe keine Ahnung. Ich habe gerade absolut keine Ahnung. Außer... June hat einfach nie existiert wirklich und die Zahl, die... Sander hatte, war einfach keine 3, sondern die 9. Und dadurch, dass sie immer zusammen durch eine Tür angeblich gegangen sind, wären 3 plus 6 wären dann sowieso 9 gewesen. Deswegen war er einfach unterbrochen die 9 und June hat nie existiert. What the fuck?
I'm a detective. I'm here to rescue you.
The rest happened just like Seven had said it did. The four of us who had stayed behind were saved by Seven. We crawled through the vent, away from the incinerator, and slid down into the hall. We came out on the other side of door 9. On the wall opposite the door was a set of double doors. Went through those and began to run up the spiral stairs. As we ran, I led the way. Behind me were Nona, my brother Aoi, Snake and Seven. The other children, the ones who had gone through the door 9 before us, were up ahead. I could hear them cheering each other on. Yeah, the stairs spiraled upward like a tornado. Eventually I pulled ahead of the rest. Perhaps Nona had slowed them down. I didn't want to lose them, so I slowed down as well. I didn't stop, but I glanced over my shoulder from time to time to see if they had caught up. That was when I realized.
Oh no, where is it? Did I drop Jumpy's present?
Come on, nine! Then I dropped it as we slid out. I had to go back. I had to. Nein, musstest du nicht! I knew I couldn't tell the others. I didn't stop to think, I simply moved. Ran to the central hall, the rooms that connected to all the other areas of the ship. I hid in the shadows, and moments later I felt a rush of wind as they ran past me up the staircase. I waited until they were out of sight, and then I ran. I moved as quietly as I could, down and down and down. Finally I reached the bottom deck. I ran into the hallway and looked around frantically.
There it is!
It was just where I thought it would be, sitting under the opening of the vent. I ran over and snatched it from the floor, but as I ran back towards the stairs and freedom... kam Hongu zurück, den wir später Ace nennen würden. Richtig.
Ah, how wonderful to see you decided to come back.
Looked mechanical, as if someone had simply pulled up the corners of his mouth.
Come with me. We must continue the experiment.
I shook my head, eyes wide. Slowly, I began to walk backwards. One step, two steps, three steps. Then I spun around and broke into a run. I felt Hongo's hand close over my left wrist.
I said, come with me.
There was an edge of insanity to his voice now. I pulled as hard as I could.
No, stop! Let go of me! Let go!
I shook my body and flailed my arms, trying desperately to get Hongo to let go of me. But I was still only a child. I was no match for a man like Hongo.
Stop struggling, goddammit! Do as I tell you!
Ich gehe da mal so ein bisschen durch, wenn sich... Wir wissen das alles. Tatsächlich, zum Großteil. Ja, und Aoi kommt auch. Der gerannt und die ganzen anderen hinterher.
You came back.
Ah, you're too late, idiot.
Hongo threw his full weight against my arm, pulling us both into the incinerator. The force of it threw me to the floor. I scrambled to my feet and looked towards the open number 9 door. Hongo stood between it and me, but behind him I could see my brother, his fist clenched. But those fists never reached Hongo. Ich werde sie geschlossen. Ja, ja, ja. With a cold, hard screech of metal on metal, the door slammed shut. I reached into his pocket and removed 2 bracelets. With them both over the scanner panel. Aber nur 2, oder? Checks the screens and toss the bracelets carelessly onto the floor. What was he doing? What was the point? He made an offer to explain himself, of course. He said nothing at all and walked past me as though I were nothing more than a rock by the roadside. A few moments later... the 2 other doors slid shut as well. Finally, I could hear someone pounding on the door behind me. I turned around and ran towards the door of the 9.
Akane! Akane! Are you okay?
I could hear a voice from the other side of the door. A worried, frightened voice.
Help me!
I thought it was already raw, but I screamed as loud as I could. My voice echoed lonely around the empty room.
What should I do? I think I'm trapped in here!
Where's Hongo?
He went out the other door!
I'm a V! Then it started again. Und ich bin wieder Junpei. Ja, ja. Holy shit. Man, I knew that it was what I was gonna say, but that is one hell of a creepy voice. It's a ganz normale Computerstimme, Mensch.
It's starting. Santa started the incinerator.
Yeah.
Fuck! Man, I never thought I'd hear that damn voice again after 9 years.
What the hell? What the hell? What in God's name are you talking about?
Einige Sachen.
It's 9 years this and 9 years that, and when it's not 9 years something, then you're talking about some sort of fucking experiment. You aren't making any sense.
Ich meine, ja. 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 Und generell ziemlich viele 9, auch wenn es nicht Jahre sind unbedingt immer.
I'm sorry, Lotus, but we really don't have time to explain it right now.
Sehe ich genauso, leider.
I'll tell you everything once we get out of here.
But...
incineration will begin in 17 minutes.
You know what that means, right? Incinerate means burn!
Ja, das weiß ich, danke. Wir sind alle erwachsen, keine Sorge.
What kind of idiot do you think I am? I know what incinerate means.
Ja, ist richtig.
Well, god damn it! Okay, okay, fine! I won't ask anything else. Talk about whatever you want. But you have to do something for me. 7, figure this out.
What? Why me?
Just shut up and stop this thing.
How the hell?
There has to be some sort of emergency shut-off button.
There isn't anything like that.
How the hell do you know?
Because I looked for it 9 years ago.
Yeah, Lotus isn't happy about that. Das weiß ich. Can't really blame her. Wait. It's the floor. It's moving. What? What's happening? Ein finales Rätsel. What else can I say about it, but...
What the hell is that?
Gute Frage. Ich bin wieder Akane.
What is that?
Ach, das ist vor 9 Jahren also auch schon passiert. Und sie konnte das Rätsel also nicht lösen vor 9 Jahren? Willst du mir das gerade sagen? What else could I say? The floor opened and a machine rose up out of it. Looked like a computer. At least it kind of did, ja, mehr oder weniger halt. There was a monitor keyboard and a cross-shaped device of some kind. Something about the machine scared me, but I forced myself to walk up to it. I was terrified. Tears poured down my face. I wiped them off, even as more took their place, and forced myself forward. Finally I reached it. Ist der Sinn der Sache gerade, dadurch, dass Akane mit uns das Bewusstsein irgendwie teilt in der Vergangenheit, soll ich jetzt die Rätsel lösen, damit sie die Lösung hat in der Vergangenheit von 9 Jahren, damit sie nicht stirbt? Ist das gerade der Punkt? Irgendwie erinnert mich das gerade ein bisschen an Your Name, muss ich sagen, das Ganze, auf irgendeiner Ebene. Aber gut, lass nur das, machen wir weiter. All I saw was my own frightened face staring back at me from the glass, drenched in tears. Ja, und du auch, nur ohne Tränen. I'm looking kind of freaked out. I know I'm sweating like crazy, but seeing it kind of drives at home. Okay, Junpei, just calm down, alright? Everything's gonna be okay. Gah! Man, I wish that thing would just shut up. Nein, 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 15 Minuten, okay, habe ich Zeit. Reicht. It's only showing up now, then it's gotta be important. But what the hell am I supposed to do with it?
Hey, move!
Gah! Hey, we all tense, lady. That doesn't mean you get to shove people around.
Okay, it's turned on. There's nothing on the screen, though. Oh, this is bad. This is really bad. If there's nothing on here, how are we supposed to do anything with it?
Well, at least it's on now. What's on the screen, though?
What is this?
What's up?
It looks like some sort of puzzle.
Ja, das sehe ich auch, danke. It's got a bunch of numbers and letters scattered across a 5x5 grid. The numbers range from 1 to 8.
Do you think that if we solve this puzzle, the incinerator will stop? Yeah, well, we can hope, right?
Alright, puzzle, how do you work? Oh man, that goddamn voice again!